Hi, everybody. So glad you're with us. Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and we welcome you to the MGM Grand here on the Vegas Strip in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada, for tonight's main event. Each man comes into this fight supremely confident, expecting to deliver a W. Mike Tyson's ring walks have become the stuff of legend, and you can see the intensity on his face.
All right, fellas, let's have a good, clean fight. Touch them up and let's go.
Everybody's been waiting for these two to meet up. Now they do, as round one is underway. Takes one, gives one. The right hand scores well. Eddie, I'm going to call this one a little baking soda and vinegar matchup. You know what happens when you put those two things together?
Yeah, you get a volcano, and it's going to explode. And I think before the night's over, you're going to see that.
Oh, what an exchange. He clinches when he gets to the inside. Takes one to give one. Uppercut in return. And he clinches yet again. That's a nice left hand from Mike Tyson. What an excellent two-punch combo by Mike Tyson. Just an excessive amount of holding here. Just much too much clinching. Nice block that time. It was intended to the head. Scores big with the hook to the head. Nice strike after catching one by Big. Tall guy versus short guy here tonight in front of us. Teddy, why does it seem so hard sometimes that some tall fighters don't necessarily fight tall?
Because, Joe, it takes great discipline to stay on the outside. You look at him, you say, hey, you're tall. I wish I was tall like that. But now it takes restraint, control to stay in those quarters and make sure you don't give in and allow the shorter guy to get close.
Tremendous body work by both guys as they stand right there on the inside and trade.
Now it's up to somebody off of that body work to bring it upstairs. Do something more than stay in the basement. Go visit the attic every once in a while.
A well-placed hook from Mike Tyson. That worked out really well. Throw it off the right hand after getting tagged like that. And we come to the end of the round. And you know his trainers gotta love that because they stress, hey, go out there and be smart with what you're doing. He was very smart about when to throw and how to land it.
And that's the key in the sweet science. Placing your punches, as you said, making them count.
Here we go. Round two is underway. That's great stuff. He fires one right back after taking one. Gotta love the work by Big. A little give and take, and here comes the left hand. Good block there by Mike Tyson. Tyson's left landing well. You see what happens when he commits to the uppercut. Look at that. Great work there. Back and forth they go, each man getting the best of it. Good return fire that time. Zoning in on that gut combination punch downstairs. Halfway through round number two. Return to sender. He gives him back one of his own. Diggs almost looking foolish that time. He missed so badly. Now he's putting his punches together. The combination upstairs. Good effective work with that straight right hand. Mike Tyson's landing a combination here. That's what he does when he's at his very best. Good clean shot, returning fire. Well done by Big. He got all into that one. That was a solid uppercut. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left-hand scores. End of this round. Joe and Teddy sitting ringside with you. It gives us time to reflect on the bigger picture of boxing. You know, it was interesting. We had a fan walk up to you earlier today and say, hey, I know you learned everything from the legendary Cus D'Amato, the great trainer. And he said to you, what's the one thing you took away from all your years with Cus? What did you say to him?
Well, it wasn't a paycheck, I'll tell you that much, because Cus didn't believe in paying you for that. He said, you're going to college, you're getting a valuable education, and you're not even being forced to pay a tuition. So I understood that. We worked 7 days a week, so there was no union. Cus believed in working on Sundays, so you couldn't go complain and say I'm being overworked. But I think, seriously, that the most important thing that I learned, of course, that from a technical standpoint, you have to be really secure in those areas. No matter how much talent a fighter has, you have to teach them right, teach them the fundamentals, but mentally. You have to understand that a fighter's really always under fear. And you have to understand those dimensions, those parameters. And you have to be able to find a way to get in there, understanding how he feels mentally, and understanding how that can impair his judgment, stop him from doing simple physical things.
He missed with that headshot. Oh, that's a big hook right there. A knifing left hand by Mike Tyson. Coming to the halfway point of this third round. Good block by Big. Takes one, but gives one. Good work by Big. He engages in the clinch. If there was a baseball umpire around, he'd call that a strikeout by Mike Tyson. He got hit right there, but he also gave one. Solid effort by Big. Exchange there. Good right hand by Big. Took a shot. Now he gives a left. Oh, that's good stuff. Fire it right back with one of his own. Good work by Big. Targeting each other. The exchange was something special. And that's the end of round three.
There you go.
Start of round number four. Tyson's accuracy has really carried this fight so far. He's up 3 rounds to 0 on your scorecard.
Yeah, and again, it's because of what you just touched on. He's been a sharpshooter all night long.
Mike Tyson with a big right hand. Took a shot, now he gives a left. Not hitting his mark there, going upstairs. He got hit, but he sends it right back. There's the hook. Well, supposed to be fighting, but instead he's hugging. Biggs missing the mark by a mile. That just was nowhere to be found. Reaching the halfway mark of this round. Tyson's doing well here with that two-punch combination. Sizzling hand speed we saw moments ago. Heck of a combination, but pretty easy to get it off when you're that fast.
Yeah, it is. And what it causes, too, is besides us saying, ooh, that we see those quick hands and the judges, you know, marking it down, also it makes the opponent keep his hands in his pocket. He's afraid to move his hands because the other guy's so much faster.
One for you now, he says. Right back with the left hand. Comes right back with some offense of his own. Back and forth exchange. How about that left hand? End of the round here. And you can see that label of volume puncher was made for this guy, as the punch stats prove true.
Yeah, he doesn't care really where he hits you. It makes you think of those stories you used to hear in the old days. Maybe your grandfather, maybe your father talked about Rocky Marciano. Loved that guy, former heavyweight champ of the world. He'd hit you anywhere. He didn't care. Back of the head, he hit you on the arms, and he'd start breaking you down. This guy doesn't care. He just throws.
All right. Oh, water up there, that's it. You don't need that. No, throw that away. I got one.
Round number five has arrived. Well-placed hook there. A solid uppercut by Big. The left hand coming into play by Mike Tyson. Mike Tyson's got speed, no doubt about it. You can see his ability to land combinations with ease.
Yeah, but what you want to see now is how effective he is down the road with that speed. Does he place his punches? Is he intelligent with that speed?
Accurate uppercut after taking a shot of his own. There's another left hand from him. Still plenty of time to work here in round number five. Minute and a half to go. Good smooth work by Big. That's classic counterpunching.
Yeah, what he did was he pulled that right shoulder back. You know, he just pulled it back, gave him the left shoulder, and then gave him the right hand.
Blocks that blow, and then a counter uppercut. What a great job. He gave one right back in return. Nice work by Big. They decide to trade there. Great work offensively landing that combination by Mike Tyson. We come to the end of the round. Joe and Teddy with you ringside. Teddy, the punch stats prove it, but obviously, listen, if you're going to work more than the other guy, you're going to win the round.
Yes, you are. Usually, as long as those punches have eyes, as long as they're getting into scoring areas, clean shots.
The start of the sixth round. Wow, look at that, trading shots. Tyson's doing good damage with the combination punching.
Well, right there's a good example of the benefit of combination punching. You miss the first or the second, the third and the fourth, they land.
Needs to improve that accuracy, missed with the headshot. strike after catching one by Big. How about a return to sender with the left hand? He gives as well as he takes. You saw it on that exchange. Halfway through this round. Oh, and he returns fire with a left hand. He's just walking him back a bit there, up against the ropes. Nothing there on the punch by Big.
Well, his opponent is opening up and coming forward, so I would think there are some opportunities that exist.
Yeah, I think some counterpunching opportunities. Opportunities not on the front end, but on the back end.
A little something for his opponent after getting tagged. What a good war this has been. What a good, solid fight it's been. The kind of fight that tells me somebody wants to get rid of the other guy.
It almost looks like they made a deal where neither one could win by decision, where if they didn't win by knockout, it doesn't count.
He looks anxious and ready to get underway here. How about that exchange? Oh, and he's got something for him himself, and it's a left hand. He scored well after being hit himself. Not much action as he just ties up. Big's doing a poor job. There's no other way to really say it. I mean, he's sitting there trying to stay committed to being a counterpuncher. But in the meantime, the fight is getting away from him in a big way.
Yeah, he needs a plan B right now. You know, he came in with plan A, Joe, but plan B is what he needs. He has to find another way to create offense. He's not going to be able to do it countering on the back end.
He takes a shot and then commits to giving one right back. Good solid shots with the combo downstairs. Big's way off the mark. That punch didn't have a chance. Seconds to go in the seventh. Very nice work from both men. They each got a shot in.
There you go. Back to back. We got it. All we need is water up there, and that's it. You don't need that, man. Throw that away.
All that hard work in training camp is now paying off. Just look at his work rate, Teddy. I've looked over at the punch stats. They're phenomenal. He's up big on your scorecard through seven.
Well, right now he's not hitting his trainer like he was a few weeks ago. You know, a few weeks ago when we talked to him before the fight, you know, he was saying about how he was being made to run on the beach, made to run those hills. Well, right now he's kind of happy he did that work.
Biggs not having the fight go his way. He's a slugger. He wants to slug it out. That's not the type of fight that's winning it right now.
Now, you put all your eggs in one basket, and that's what he's done. He doesn't know any other way, and guess what? You get an omelet, or he's being made into scrambled eggs.
What a smart combination by Mike Tyson. Halfway point of round number eight. Good doubling up of the jab by Big. He gets hit, but he gives it right back. To nab him up top, but was unable to connect. See, the defense pays off as he gets rid of that downstairs. Here in these later rounds, you can start to see a trend, and one is developing. He cannot get away from that left hand.
Now listen, when you throw your punches, it's not enough just to chuck them out there. You gotta throw them from the right distance. He's throwing them from a little too close, where he's vulnerable, as you said, to that left hand.
You gotta watch the water in the corner. Come on.
They are back to action here, but that action has only favored one man, completely one-sided. Hard to see the scorecards coming into play here with how dominating he's been. That's a forceful two-punch combo by Mike Tyson. That's great stuff. He fires one right back after taking one. Gotta love the work by Big. Seconds into the ninth round. Well-targeted two-punch combo by Big. And he's holding. Another clinch. Doubles up the jab. Final chance, last 10 seconds of round nine. We come to the end of this round, and for this fighter, I think that's a good thing because I was looking at him there, Teddy, and looked like he was breathing in and out of his mouth for most of that round.
Yeah, and that's a bad sign. That means that the gas tank is a little low. He's low on petrol.
Put him in there. Yeah. You gotta watch the water in the corner. Come on.
Another round, will it go in another one-way direction? It's been a one-sided fight so far tonight. That was not well targeted by Big. Comes right back at him with a left hand. Big's thinking right now that he's doing a good job defensively, but it's really not the case, Teddy. Every so often, you will see a punch split that guard.
Yeah, he's just standing there. First of all, the gloves, he needs to extend them just a little bit away. So as you said, those punches, you know, aren't going to force their way through to the target, which they're doing right now. They're getting down to him. They're getting through to him.
Right back at him. Pulls the trigger right away with the left hand after getting tagged himself. And now they're trading blows. Right hand is becoming a crutch. He can just lean on it now. Coming to the end of round number 10, 10 seconds to go. Comes right back at him with a left hand.
We got it. All right. All we need is water up there, and that's it. You don't need that now. Throw that away.
Try as they may, Big's corner has been unable to fix what looks like a broken Humpty Dumpty face on there. As we start round 11, the scorecard and his face tell the story. Missed that shot up top. Tyson's making for a very, very difficult night for his opponent. His opponent knew this was coming. He knew he was going to fight on the outside, but the jab is really doing damage.
Well, his opponent knew this was coming. Why is he not blocking that jab or moving his head and getting away from it?
Not what he was looking for. That's a miss right there by Mike Tyson. Last 10 seconds of this 11th round.
Tyson's trainer, who you can see working with him right now in between rounds, said, hey, you've never seen anything like the way he works a double end bag. It's proven true.
Yeah, it has. You know, part of why he's so accurate is he's calm, but part of it is he works on it like you just said. He gets on that crazy bag, that double end bag, and he makes sure that those punches are right on the mark.
Now we're underway in what has been a completely one-sided fight. You get the sense this one may not go the distance. Good, strong uppercut. He comes right back with it after taking one. A headshot blocked. Not an accurate hook at all. Good exchange. He fires back. Tyson's realizing right now that this jab is working out beautifully. Teddy, why has he been so successful with it?
Well, first of all, it's a pure jab. You know, it's a real clean jab. There's no warning. It doesn't raise the elbow. It shoots right from that shoulder. You don't see it coming.
Halfway through this round here. He returns the favor with a right hand of his own. Took a shot, now he gives a left. And that's what fighters do. Pulls the trigger right away after taking one.
Keep it going.
Puts one in there. And he returns on that exchange. They both decide to bring it. And the bell rings, signifying the end of the round. Tyson's in a position now where he should be able to bring home a win. If things stay the way they are, he's clearly headed towards a win.
Yeah, I have my head on my scorecard, but he has to make sure he doesn't, like in football, go into that prevent defense. If he starts just moving, just staying away a little bit, now the things that were keeping his opponent from coming in that front door, well, guess what? They're not there no more. His opponent could get back into this fight.
You gotta watch the water in the corner. Come on.
Another round underway, but how many more will we see? You get the sense this fight could be heading towards a stoppage. And you can see he wanted to do that as he holds on there. Not able to land the headshot. Two good jabs by Mike Tyson. Protecting his head well with his guard. A little give and take, and here comes the left hand. Comes right back with a shot of his own. 90 seconds to go here in this round. Blocked that away. It was targeted for his head. Good work toe-to-toe there. Both fighters got in on him.
All right, let's do it.
shot, returning fire. Well done by Biggs. There is hardly a doubt as to what this result will be. I know anything can happen, but all that's happened all night long is one guy punishing the other.
Well, it looks like Kobe Bryant on a good night when that basket is 20 feet big. I mean, he just can't miss.
Again, back to action here with another round, but who knows how much longer it'll last. This has been a completely one-sided fight. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left hand scores. Tyson's making for a tough target there. He gets away from that punch. A well-placed, gutsy uppercut after being tagged. Super two-punch combo by Mike Tyson. Good return fire that time. And coming upon the halfway mark of this three-minute round. Combination to the head. Seconds remaining in this round. So another round comes to an end that, Teddy, when you put pen to paper, you're putting down the very same way. He's up by a lot here.
Yeah, he is up by a lot. And the good news for him is he's up by a lot in his kind of fight. You know, it's going to pay the kind of pace he wants and in the dimensions that he wants.
That uppercut, and now just wasting everybody's time holding on. Good defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault. Right back with the left hand. Blocks away that headshot. You can see he's trying to score up top, but off the mark there. 90 seconds to go in the fight. Last minute of this last round. Yeah, Oh, he took some damage, but he gave some back with the right hand. Seconds to go in this, the final round. Takes one, but gives one. Good work by Big. From start to finish, it was utter domination.
This was an easy one to score, Joe.
As for that expected outcome, we send it up to the ring to hear from the judges. So a unanimous decision win by Mike Tyson. That's the way we saw it all night long. The judges agree.
It was hard to see it any other way.
Alongside Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Thanks for being with us. We'll see you next time ringside.